And then I'm just going to kind of take my fork and go down this. Just kind of show you what it looks like on the inside there. See that? Nice. Hello and welcome to In the Kitchen with Matt. I am your host, Matt Taylor. Today, I'm going to show you how to make two ingredient dough cinnamon rolls. These are super easy and quick to make, and they taste awesome. Down below in the description box, you'll find a list of the ingredients and their amounts. Now I'm gonna begin with 1 cup or 120 grams of self-rising flour. And I'm gonna put that in this medium bowl here. And then I have 5.3 ounces or 150 grams of plain Greek yogurt. And that's all we need. And if you can't get your hands on plain Greek yogurt or just yogurt in general, you could also use sour cream. And then I'm just gonna start with this little spoon. Just kind of push that yogurt in with the flour. Also preheat the oven to 375 degrees Fahrenheit or 190 Celsius. And then I usually will switch over to just my hands, very clean hands, and we're just going to blend this together until it forms a dough. And kind of just push it in together. Okay, and then once it comes together like this, it's not gonna make a ton of dough. This makes like 10 to 12 small little cinnamon rolls, so it's a great little small batch cinnamon roll recipe. Like if you don't have a lot of people that you wanna feed, this works perfect. And then just put this on a counter, and we're gonna knead this for 2 to 3 minutes, just until the dough comes all together. Okay, and then I'm just going to kind of form it into a ball here, and just press it down into a disc. And then I'm gonna cover it with a kitchen towel, and just let it rest for about 10 to 15 minutes. Once we have let it rest, what I wanna do is I wanna make the filling. I have about 1/3 cup of brown sugar here, and that is right around, what is it, 67, 65 grams, somewhere around there. And then I'm going to use a couple tablespoons of butter and a couple teaspoons of cinnamon. This is like, I don't know, 6 grams of cinnamon and 24, 25 grams of butter. And I'm just gonna melt this in the microwave, 10, 20, 25 seconds until it's melted. All right, there we go. And I'm just going to pour this. And if it's not completely melted, that's fine. Even if it's just softened butter, that is fine as well. And then I'll put that cinnamon in there as well. And if you wanted to, you could add a little splash of vanilla extract to this as well. And then I'm just going to mix this together until it forms a paste. All right, there we go, a nice little paste. And that becomes the filling for the cinnamon rolls. Now let's roll this dough out. And we just want to do a nice little rectangle here. It doesn't have to be perfect. And now we're going to take this paste and we're just going to spread it on. And you could use a cake spatula for this. You could just use the back of your spoon, like I'm doing. Whatever you want to do. Excellent. Something like that is fine. And now we want to roll this up really tightly. And so I'm going to go lengthwise here and just kind of go in this way. We'll go this way. Just nice, tightly rolled. Okay. There it is. And then a fun way to cut these, something I learned many, many years ago, over 30 years ago, I learned this, is you take a piece of floss and you go under it and then you cross it and just pull and it makes a cut. And you can't just cut it with your knife, but sometimes it'll smash the dough around it, but anyway, you can do that. A 6-inch cake pan, because I like them to be kind of smushed together a little bit when they bake. Okay, now into the oven this goes. Again, 375 Fahrenheit or 190 Celsius, and we're gonna bake it for 15 to 20 minutes until nice and golden brown. On to that step. All right, and when they come out of the oven, they will look something like this, depending on the size of your pan. If you use a larger baking pan, then they will probably have spread out a little bit and maybe even opened up. But there you go. And now I wanna make the glaze. You can do an easy, simple, two-ingredient glaze like I am doing, or you could do like a cream cheese frosting, totally up to you. I have about a cup of powdered sugar here, and I'm just gonna add a little bit of milk, just a couple teaspoons of milk at first. Don't wanna add it all at once because we wanna control the consistency. You can make this glaze as thick or as thin as you want. I'm gonna do just a little bit more. All right, so I like it kind of like this, a nice thick glaze. And then I want to just put some on these cinnamon rolls. And there we go, awesome. And then I'm gonna come in here and use my cake spatula and dig one of these out. Like I said, these are gonna be smaller, more like cinnamon roll bites. But look at that. Just kind of like a quick recipe for, you know, just a couple servings. Maybe two or three people this will serve, and you could always double or triple the recipe if you wanna make more cinnamon rolls. Awesome. And then I'm just going to kind of take my fork and go down this. Just kind of show you what it looks like on the inside there, see that? Nice. See how it tastes? Mmm. Super delicious. If you love cinnamon rolls, give this quick, easy recipe a try. Two ingredient dough cinnamon rolls. If I can do it, you can do it. I'm Matt Taylor. This has been another episode of In the Kitchen with Matt. Thank you for joining me. As always, if you have any questions, comments, or requests, put them down below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thumbs up, down the corner, press it. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and check out my other videos. Take care. Time for me to dive into this some more. Oh yeah. Mm-mm-mm.